Now it's clear to me we miscommunicated. You equivocated. You've already moved on. I'm alone and so damn jaded. And I hate it.
Just be who you're meant to be. You're a
will not work at all.
Life's full of surprises. I must have a lucky star above. At every turn, good fortune arises. Finding you and falling in love. Just when I think I know what's in store.
Have you ever heard the statement, you don't attract in life what you want, you attract in life who you are? And that's absolutely true, because we live in a universe that is responsive to your vibration. It's just like that old school radio. When it's tuned to a particular frequency, the experience of that frequency is what's aligned with it. You're going to get a song that's only tuned to that frequency. You change the frequency, you're going to get a different song. So if your major feeling tone is you're discouraged, you're lonely, you're thinking there's no guys out there or it will never happen for you, guess what you're going to attract? Circumstances that align with that result. On the other hand, if you're tuned to and you're feeling joy and hope and love, and connected to possibilities, then that's what you're going to attract in life. Whatever your major dominant vibration is what you attract in your life. And here's the beauty and the most important point. You get to choose what your vibration is going to be. And you choose that based on what thoughts you think. You get to choose how you feel. Your feelings aren't dictated by what's going on out there. Your feelings are not controlled by external circumstances. You get to choose how you're going to feel. And when you choose to feel the way you would feel as if you're already in the relationship, then you align with circumstances, events, and opportunities that bring that relationship into your life. Now, Pastor John Gray describes this principle in one of his sermons perfectly. Check this out. He says this. Here's what the scripture says. He who finds a wife finds a good thing. It didn't say, he who finds a girl who he's attracted to, who he then begins to date, who he then calls his girlfriend, who he then buys a ring for and proposes to and makes her his fiance, who then marries her later, who becomes his wife. You're not a wife when I marry you. You're a wife when I find you. You become my wife when I marry you. The wife is not the presence of a ring. It's the presence of your character. A wife is not the presence of a ring. It's the presence of your character. I love that. So the question then we can ask ourselves is, okay, well, what character then is aligned with the version of you who's already in the amazing relationship that you want? Now, I've had the privilege of literally coaching thousands of women around the world and asking them, those who have manifested their man, attracted the relationship, who are you being and how does it feel now that you're in that relationship? And the cool thing is they've shared three common feeling tones, three common vibrations they all share once they're in the relationship. And so that's exactly what you and I are going to unpack here today. I'm going to share with you what these three things are so that you can choose, if you want to embody this character, to embody this vibration, and then attract the result of your relationship into your life even faster. So the first way to raise your love vibration, to match the version of you who's in the relationship, is to choose love and acceptance. All these women talked about this feeling of love and acceptance that they have in this relationship, that their man loves them, their man cherishes them, he accepts her for who she is. But she needed to learn to love and accept herself first, to really generate that state of love and accepting, not just the parts of her that she likes, but the parts of her that she doesn't like as well, all of her. And why would love and acceptance matter? Because love and acceptance attracts love and acceptance. When you love and accept yourself to greater degrees, you attract someone who will also love and accept you and love and accept themselves. So it's this beautiful environment of love and acceptance. So the question is, what in you needs your love and acceptance right now? Choose that for yourself. Live from a state of love and acceptance, and you will open doorways of possibility into your life. Now, you might be thinking this is easy to do, or if you're like most of us, loving and accepting yourself isn't the easiest thing to take on. In fact, it's one of the more hard things to take on, which is why I want to give you a gift, a complimentary ebook and meditation. I call it the Self-Love Activation Kit. And so you listen to this meditation, you read the affirmations in the ebook, and it will begin to unlock your heart and really open you up to being able to love and accept all of yourself in even deeper ways. So I'm going to put the link to that Self-Love Activation Kit in the description. It's free. It's a gift from me to you. Check that out and help and allow that to help raise your love and acceptance vibration. This brings us to number two. The second feeling that people live from when they're in the relationship that they love is a sense of gratitude. They're so grateful for this person in their life. They're so grateful for the relationship, for the love they share, for the adventures they're able to have. There's this overwhelming feeling of gratitude rises up in them. And so there was a woman I was coaching who was asked to generate more gratitude in her life. And so she said, well, what can I do to generate gratitude? And she recognized that she loved dancing and she let dancing fall by the wayside. She'd gotten really busy at work. And so she said, you know, I'm going to pick up dancing again. And so she signed up for a dance class called Five Rhythms. Took the class, loved it, was so grateful for that class and what it did for her. And she added that to her online profile. She said, hey, I'm taking Five Rhythms dance class. And from that new vibration and that action, a guy reached out to her and said, you take Five Rhythms? I love Five Rhythms. That was their connection point. They started talking. They found that they had all kinds of common interests together. They dated and created a beautiful, amazing relationship with one another. But it started with her choosing gratitude. She didn't wait for something to happen before she felt gratitude. She actively cultivated it in her own heart. So my question is, what can you do to cultivate gratitude today? Not tomorrow, not next week, but right now. How can you generate gratitude in your heart right now and align with that love vibration? And the third vibration, the third experience that these women felt when they were in the relationship is they felt their heart fully open. Their heart was open. Their heart wasn't guarded. It wasn't closed down. They didn't have walls around their heart protecting themselves. Their heart wasn't filled with resentment from a past relationship. When they're in the relationship, their heart is open because they're giving and receiving love from this wonderful person that they're with. Now, that's not to say you're careless with your heart or that you give undeserving trust to someone who's going to be careless with your heart. But it does mean that you lead with an open heart and then give opportunities for people to earn your trust. I can still remember exactly what it felt like when I decided to open my heart and it changed everything for me. Because what I was doing is leading in relationships with a guarded heart. I wanted a sure thing. I wanted to know that I wasn't going to get hurt, that she was fully into me and I was going to fully be into her before I opened my heart. But the problem is, if you don't open your heart, you can't fully be into someone. I couldn't find myself really falling in love with someone. I was blocking my own self, and I was blocking them from really connecting to me either. I had to let go of the fear of getting hurt and open my heart before I allowed love in. It's a prerequisite. So the question for you is, what would it take for you to open your heart? What fears must you let go of for you to move forward with an open heart to really receive your person into your life? So love and accept yourself, fill your heart with gratitude, and lead with an open heart. These were three things that women had to do in order to attract their love of their life. My question for you is, when you think about the version of you who's already in the relationship and you connect to her, how does she feel? What are three feeling tones, three vibrations, if you will, that she experiences when she's in the relationship? Post that in the comments below. We'll love to check those out. And if you like this video and you love more videos like this, click the subscribe button and click the little bell, because every week we bring you videos to empower you, inspire you, uplift you in your love life. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. I'll see you soon.